1, 2, 3, 4.
Here's the manipulation cards.
they tell the rest story about this. Once again, I'm going to let you know it's extra thin and best for manipulation, especially for the signal card and any kind of production. However, without the holder, you will be unable to take any kind of loads. So with the cable, you'll get a holder as well. It's a specially handmade design holder with the elastic. So I'll let you know how do you go ahead and put the cards into the holder. Okay, so first of all, I would like you to practice with 10 or 12 cards. It depends. Now, once you master, you can go in with 20 cards or 25 cards. Now, let me take 12 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna pull this elastic over. There's an elastic, and you just have to slightly bend the cards like this and insert slightly into the elastic holder. It's completely gripped into the holder. You can see in all the sides. So, you need to apply a little bit of pressure in order to pull this card out. However, before that, you need to hide this into your coat pocket or anywhere, wherever you like. But what I would suggest at the first time is you hide it over here or you pin it over to this place, so that it will be very easier for you to pick up the cards like this. So once you take out the card from the holder, what you'll have to do is, you'll have to make sure that at the same time you palm the card over here. That means, if you see properly, this card is designed in such a way, it's suitable for your skin. That means the color will merge to your skin. So the back of the cards is not visible even in close-up. So once you palm like this, you need to pull the card like this. Now I'll let you know how to do it. This is called as single card production. That means the card comes out of nowhere in the air. You need a little bit of practice, and the card is very suitable for this. So you might not need a heavy practice hours, like 5 to 6 hours every day. Even if you take a half an hour of practice, you will be master in a week's time. Okay? So, first of all, let's forget about the holder. Let's think of how to palm the card. Now, you need to palm the card over here. Now, this should be between your forefinger and the pinky finger. Okay, so once it's palmed, you can grip it, you can hold it like this, or you can hold it tightly as well, depending upon your finger size. Now once it's done, the angle should be like this while you're performing it to the audience. That's because if you move like this, the right side audience can watch the palming. They will understand there are some cards behind your hand. And if you go ahead and perform like this, the left side audience will not be able to see your performance, as well as sometimes they will be able to see your card behind. Okay? So always, let's keep it very simple. It should be straight to the background and parallel to the hip. That's it. Now, another advantage of this card is, at the back side of the card, with the skin color, that means with the flesh color, you have a black colored back of the card. I'll tell you why. It's very useful when you manipulate in the stage, because most of the time the screen color will be black or blue. So this portion will be merged to the screen. If you watch over here, At the edge, you have a flesh color, and at the middle, there is a black color. The main part is the plumbing. So, what you are doing over here is, you need to place the card behind your finger. Okay? Behind your finger, behind your hand. And you need to grip it like this. Now, it's between your forefinger and the pinky finger. Okay, so even if you does not grip any single finger, the card will go like this. That shouldn't happen. So it has to grip properly over here. You can use your thumb for the grip like this. You can use your thumb. Now it's not visible. Now, pulling out the card from nowhere, your thumb works like a gentleman over here. Okay? So your thumb should be very quick and your forefinger and pinky finger should be gripped. What you're gonna do is you have to use your thumb, just hold the tip of the card like this. Very simple. You just have to slide the card. That's it. I'm not gonna use a term called as pull the card, because if I say pull, what you will do is you will try to separate one card and then you will try to pull. Don't worry, that's not the method. The only thing you'll have to take care is just slide the card like this. Just slide the card with the thumb. So when you're sliding card, some people might think, okay, it's not coming. So what you can do is, you can just wetten your thumb like this and you can pull. You will get some more grip in order to slide the card. So you need to practice this slowly like this. So if you see over here properly, none of my finger is moving apart from my thumb and the forefinger. Now the reason you need to separate your forefinger while your thumb is sliding the card, because the card has to come out smoothly. And simultaneously, while you are sliding it with the thumb, while the card is at the front side, you need to again grip the card with the forefinger. I'll show you step by step right now. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the fourth step should be the thumb sliding the card and the forefinger simultaneously coming to the grip. It's very simple. You need to practice for a week. That's it. And now, I'll show you in this way. In this way, you can do it very smoothly. 1, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And you can go on producing, you can produce fast or you can produce slow. However, it's your wish. Teach you an extra move, which is very useful for any kind of card surface. You might have learned the single card right now, you might have seen about it. Now, what's this? Very simple. First, I'm going to show it to you. Have a card over here, it vanishes in the air. both the sides like this. And now I'll teach you how did I do this. This is as same as a single card manipulation. The palming works the same way. Okay? First of all, you need to hold the card like this. The angle is the same, which I told you. And you need to hold the two middle fingers over here. So again, the pinky finger and the forefinger works for a grip. And just turn it like this. Now the card is vanished. So you need to practice this a lot more time before you show both your hand, both the side of the hand. So watch this carefully. First, I'm going to vanish this, and then while I'm turning my hand, my two middle fingers will go like this and just cover up. Now this should happen in a fraction of seconds. Same way, while you're showing the other side, you need to push the card like this. Watch this carefully. And turn the palm. Now, people feel that there's no card at the palm side as well as at the back side. So the card is completely vanished. And while you're producing, same like the single card, you just have to slide it. That's it. Now, there are a lot more ways where you can vanish this. You can also vanish the card like this. Watch carefully.
Okay, dear friends, as Samarth told us now, I'll take 13 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 cards. He said 12 or 13 cards, no problem. Now he asked me to hold between this pinky and this forefinger. Like this?
Exactly.
Okay. Now, I'll wet my thumb and I hold like this, right? Then I pull this.
Exactly.
Like this. See what happens, sometimes it comes out, then what I have to do?
You just have to make sure that
you don't leave the grip.
Yeah, don't leave the grip. And what you can do is another way while you're performing it, that happens. You can act like you're taking this card
at the same time you reload it.
Reload.
Okay.
Perfect. And most of the time, we can also start with 5 or 6 cards.
Okay, as he said, all that we have to do is take about 12 cards and palm it like this, and you pull this like this and drop it. See?
Now let me show you another method. Let's palm this card, okay, at the back side. Okay. Now tighten your finger completely, the forefinger and the pinky finger. Now it's tight. Now, by using the thumb, yes. No, you know, sometimes it will happen at the first time, but then.
You have to keep at the back, you mean?
Yeah, back.
Instead of front, back.
Instead of front, you can try it back side. Both are the correct way. You don't need to worry about it. Both are the correct way. Okay. Now, if this happens, what you can do is, let's do it very slowly. Check this out. Over here, I'm just lifting the forefinger, but I'm not losing the grip.
Like this?
Yes. I'm just lifting the forefinger, but the grip is not losing over here.
Okay.
Now the forefinger is completely gripped. Now, yeah. Yes. Now you don't lose the grip. Sometimes it will happen while you are doing it the first time, and once you practice for a week or so, it will be perfect.
Now I got it.
Yes. Perfect.
So all that you have to do is pull from here.
Exactly.
Not from the front.
That's true.
I have seen some performers, they perform like this. They pull from here. See, from here. If you pull from here, they can see the cards.
Exactly.
It is better you pull from here, so they can't see this. See? Like this.
And whenever if the card falls, it's mandatory that first time while we are performing, the card will fall. And
so don't worry.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
So now I think I started getting it.
Okay. So, just a second. Okay.
See, this is the position where you have to hold it. Let it be here and pull it this way.
Yes.
See.
Okay. Two methods. One, you can palm at the very edge, and one, you can do it like this,
which is better.
Both are better. However, it's upon you. How big is your finger? If your finger is much more bigger, you can use this. And if your finger is small, you can use this.
I feel the palming at the back is better because they can't see much. If they are the tip of your finger, they can see from here.
Exactly.
See, this is easier, but I don't advise you to palm here. You can produce from here, but I feel, as Samar said, back side is better so that cards won't be visible
exactly
much. And if you palm from the back, you don't see much. See? Like this.
And one more advantage we have in this particular card, in this manipulation card, is if you palm completely at the back, okay, we can
even separate your fingers. Okay.
Separate.
Open your fingers because this is black. The background is also black. It will not be visible. See?
Exactly.
See, as Samar said, it is not difficult. Believe me, I am just practicing now itself. I haven't done this before. That's why I am getting little hard, but I am sure within weeks time I will be able to do this. In the beginning it happens like that, but don't worry. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6.
Within a week you can master it.
What I feel, you don't hold this, don't press it much. Hold it smoothly. Don't put much pressure. Then I feel it's easier for you to produce it. Don't press much. In the beginning, as you have to practice, you may have to hold tight. But slowly you have to reduce the grip on the edges, then it will be easier for you to produce like this.
So you might not know the actual grip. So I would suggest you take a couple of extra pack of cards so that it will be very easier for you to practice.
Oh yeah, you go use, as I told you, while practicing after a few times, this is only during practice, you have to place your cards a reverse side like this and produce. This I have practiced. I advise you to practice this first with these two fingers. Put your finger inside and do this vanishing and production. Once you get grip to these fingers, then you can go with more cards. Wet your finger, show this. And pull this. 1, 2.
At the very starting stage, what you can do is you can keep your hand like this, straight to the face, and you can see you producing the cards. How good you are producing. Like this. Like this. So you don't need a mirror for this to see how good you are doing. You can just keep the hand like this and start producing. Now, the reason it's getting slipped from your forefinger is because you need to grip this particular portion. Exactly. And yeah, now it's moving. So even if you lift this forefinger, this grip will not be move from here. Perfect. Now it's perfect. Exactly. Yeah. Great. So you need to practice this a lot more time, like 10 to 15 times a day. And once you're through with it, even if you want the car to be, slip from there, it will not fall. So now it's getting it right.
Now I'll practice in front of you. Let's see how it happens. So palm like this. Do it slowly like this while you practice. What I suggest you when you do, catch as if you are catching cards from the back. See? Okay, thanks for teaching. All the best.